This is Chronicle on WCVB Channel 5.
Clay Soper's fatal mistake, mixing alcohol and Xanax.
And every day we miss him.
Now his family is telling his story to save others' grief.
Tell me why it was important for you to make this documentary.
If we can get that word out, we're gonna save lives.
Also tonight, giving little Rebecca hope at Franciscan Children's.
She's seen by physical therapy, occupational therapy, speech and respiratory.
Training the nurses of tomorrow at Laboray.
We need more nurses.
And Margaret Blood's mission, feeding the hungry kids of Guatemala.
For $13, a donation would feed a child for a month.
The Givers, next on Chronicle.
Good evening. How do you make sense out of a tragedy? For Jeff and Jenny Sopers of Winchester, it's by sharing the lessons of their son's death.
Clay Soper died from a fatal mix of alcohol and medication. Clay's family tells his story in a new documentary.
For any parent, the loss of a child brings unimaginable sorrow. No one knows that more than the Sopers of Winchester. 3 years ago, the family's 19-year-old son, Clay, a bubbly kid with a world of promise, died tragically after mixing the prescription drug Xanax with heavy drinking.
Our son, Clay, was a really fun kid. He was smart, he was athletic, he was happy, he was engaged in everything he did, and he was a joy to be around.
The death of Clay Soper the summer after his college sophomore year stunned Winchester. But rather than retreat from the world paralyzed in grief, the Sopers decided to make a documentary, sounding a call to action. The movie features the Winchester friends who were with Clay the night of his death and warns of the potentially lethal effects of mixing alcohol with prescription drugs.
I wouldn't wish this upon anyone. You know, Clay's friends that went through this with him are changed people. Our community is a changed community. Clay was not the kind of kid that anyone ever suspected would die like this.
Clay was in fact an awesome kid, say the Sopers. But he made a poor choice that night of partying, and his friends compounded the problem by further making bad decisions. Instead of calling 911, they thought Clay could sleep it off. Instead, he died.
Tell me why it was important for you to make this documentary.
It was important to me because I feel like had Clay known, had we known, had the kids at the party known about the risks of what they did that night or how they handled the aftermath of the situation, if we can get that word out, then we're going to save lives.
The documentary, called If They Had Known, takes aim at today's high school and college party culture, where drinking to excess is pervasive. It is gut-wrenching and honest.
I want Clay to be remembered forever, and I want his spirit to live on. He's one of the most unique people I've ever met, and I hate that I don't have him. I hate that I don't have him to text or call or send a stupid Snapchat to.
And how are you doing since Clay's passing?
I think I'm doing very well relative to, you know, what I thought I would have been, how I would have been doing. But I think part of that is because we have this cause to rally around. And that gives Jenny and I and our family an incredible sense of fulfillment that, that Clay didn't die for no reason.
The Sopers would love to have the documentary seen in every high school and college in America. They're also screening it for lots of healthcare providers.
The number of pediatricians who are the people prescribing a lot of these drugs to teens had no concept that this was a recreational trend. I was astounded by the number of pediatricians that said, I didn't even know this was happening.
At college and high school screenings, often accompanied by a family member, the Sopers pass out cards for audience reactions.
One high school student wrote, as a regular mixer of Xanax and alcohol, I will never do it again after seeing this film. Some speak to the point that they've never ever considered what they do would have an effect on their family.
The Sopers say if this could happen to their son, Clay, it could happen to any young adult. Clay was a good, spirited kid who loved skiing so much he volunteered for a program called Yes, which brought inner city kids to the slopes of New England. In his college application, Clay wrote that he got more out of helping disadvantaged Boston teens than he gave.
What do you miss most about him?
His laugh and his smile and his craziness. He was just a lot of fun. And every day, my life has changed. And every day we miss him. And every day I'm astounded that something like this could have happened to us or our family.
I think it's important to bring light to this issue because it really just shouldn't have happened. Clay was so unique, such a gift to this world, that anything that my family and I can do to prevent this from happening to anybody else is kind of what I see as we have to do.
What would he say about what you guys are doing now in his honor?
I think he would have been really proud of his family. I think at some point we're probably gonna see him again. And he'll give us a big hug.
Oh my gosh, and the Sopers tell us they've had inquiries from more than 300 high schools, colleges, substance abuse organizations, religious groups, and right now they have more than 50 showings scheduled. There's a lot of interest.
Yeah, and they also continue to hear from parents, teachers, school administrators saying that the problem is also happening in their communities. And if you want to learn more, if you are interested in scheduling a showing, please check out our website, wcvb.com/chronicle.
Up next, families count the days to recovery at Franciscan Children's.
Sometimes 40 to 60 to 80 days.